Good day, everyone. Today's Virtual Agent Academy subject is on localization. The agenda and the goals for today, I've broken down the main subject of localization into three parts. First two are on the Virtual Agent Designer and the Virtual Agent Web Client. On these, I'll discuss and demonstrate localization for specific languages, though also for the English language. Third and last part is about some need-to-knows and limitations concerning localization. We will not be covering anything on NOU today, basically because up to the Orlando release, NOU is only available for the English language. With the Paris release, French and German have been added. You might get some ideas already for NOU after this Virtual Agent Academy, and I'll just post a question on the ServiceNow community. So this is me, Mark Rudolph, working for Quinn Technology as a technical consultant. Quinn Technology is a ServiceNow partner based in the Netherlands. I'm working now on ServiceNow for a bit over 3.5 years. And I'm a member of this year's ServiceNow Developer and Community MVP class. And when not working for Quinton Technology, I'm spending a lot of my time in professional basketball. I'm a second assistant coach at Lonsdale Hammers. So the first part of today's Virtual Agent Academy, localization for the Virtual Agent Designer, the area where you are designing your actual Virtual Agent topics. When discussing localization, we will have a look at specific languages, though also the English language. Adding strings in Dutch, German, and other languages, which is pretty common, though it's also about changing strings in English. We will have a look at what we can do with that. You might already notice on the image on this slide, prefixes are shown. This is done with using the I18N debugging, which shows translation prefixes on strings. These prefixes indicate which strings can be translated and which table contains the string and translation. Concerning the Virtual Agent Designer, most prefixes you see are concerning MSG, which stands for UI messages. You might also come across some others. Especially TRT is a good one to mention. This is about translated text, which will be used for the virtual agent topic names. I'm not demonstrating that one today, though in one of the upcoming slides, I have mentioned a community article which explains this in detail. So when working within the virtual agent designer, and adding messages, you would do this through the string expression element or through script. Using the string expression, you would type in your message or you can add data pills or even a combination of both. If using the script field concerning localization, it's important to add gs.getMessage. Try to make a habit of this. Even if your instance is at this moment single language, who knows, maybe in the near future you will support another language. Or what about if you would like to change English strings, and especially strings which are used in multiple places, multiple topics? Then you do need to support the usage of UI messages. So applying gs.getMessage in your script. I've also added gs.getMessageLang on this slide. Today's Virtual Agent Academy is too short to also look into this, though it's basically a more advanced way of applying UI messages, where you can select a specific language. There's not much documentation on the ServiceNow docs or developer site on gs.getMessageLang, so I'm currently writing a community article on this topic. And the actual UI messages, most important of using UI messages, the key and language should match. And if it matches, the message value will automatically be applied within the Virtual Agent web client. So let's jump into a ServiceNow instance for a short demo. And let's start off immediately with enabling the I18N debugging. So that's under system localization and then enable I18N debugging. Now opening the web client again. Notice, that prefixes are shown now, like here, MSG, MSG. This indicates that, for example, this string can be translated by use of UI messages. And actually, this one has no prefix. I'll show that later. So let's have a look at the Virtual Agent Designer and the greetings topic which we saw. This should look familiar. Just a bot response text. And here a string expression has been applied. So let's search for this string expression within the UI messages, which you can find under system localization and then messages. So let's type in the message. And in this case, there's one UI message record for the Dutch language. So if you would like to change the message in Dutch, you can just update the message here. So what if we would like to change this message in English? If there is no UI message record yet, you can just add it. So we'll just add one now. We've got the key here, English, and let's just type in a message. How can I help you today? And let's add Virtual Agent Academy. So let's go back to the Virtual Agent web client. Let's see if our new updated message has been applied. Yeah, and indeed, here we already see our new message. So that's already how basic localization on the Virtual Agent Designer works for the English language. I will show an example of a specific language like Dutch in the second part of today's Virtual Agent Academy. The first message though, good evening. As mentioned, the MSG prefix is not shown. So UI messages won't be applied on this one at this moment. So let's have a look at that one. Going to the Virtual Agent Designer again. That first message is coming from this bot response text. And actually, this message has been scripted. So let's open the script. And on lines 9, 11, 13, 15, several messages are shown. And what I mentioned before, when scripting messages, you should make a habit of applying gs.getMessage. And that's what is missing here. That's immediately why the MSG prefix is missing on the Virtual Agent web client. So let's just add gs.getMessage. Let's save, publish, and opening the web client again. Yeah, and indeed, now the prefix is shown. So theoretically now, also the good evening message concerning localization should behave the same like our previous example. So again, when scripting messages, make a habit of applying gs.getMessage. Yeah, so that's already a short demonstration on localization on the virtual agent designer. Yeah, not much to it. So let's proceed with the second part of today's Virtual Agent Academy, as it is closely related. The second part is on localization for the Virtual Agent web client. Yeah, and again, like the first part of today's Virtual Agent Academy, when discussing localization, we will have a look at specific languages, though also the English language. The left side image shown is in the English language, and we will look into what we can do with a string like show me everything, or on the bottom left, please type your request. The same we will also do for a specific language, which is shown on the right side image. In this example, Dutch. Yeah, most strings on this image are prefixed. This is the same as what we saw with the strings for the virtual agent designer. This is done with using the i18 debugging. And concerning the virtual agent web client, most prefixes you will see are also on MSG. In some cases, using the debugging, you will not see prefixes like this one. This is the chat header. And this actually indicates that the chat header cannot be influenced concerning localization. I've also circled the just now string. You could influence this one with UI messages, though be aware this is a generic used string. So if changing this specifically for virtual agent, the changes are also visible on other areas within your ServiceNow instance. Yeah, we saw the show me everything prefixed with MSG. If we would like to change this string in English, we would have a look at the UI message table and search for records with show me everything. For the record with language English, we would just update the message value. And on the bottom image, I've added examples of a specific language, in this case, Dutch. And actually, all the UI messages shown on this image already exist out of the box. For most strings within the virtual agent, out of the box UI messages are available. So let's jump into the ServiceNow instance for a short demo. Here we have the virtual agent web client. And if we look at the bottom left, notice the prefix shown on please type your request. So let's just demonstrate changing this particular string. It's prefixed with MSG. So we should be able to do this with UI messages. So here we have the UI messages, system localization, and then messages. Let's search for the please type your request. One record is shown for the Dutch language. We will just add a UI message for the English language. It's similar like what we saw in the first part of today's Virtual Agent Academy. Language is English, and here you can enter your request here. And again, adding something like VAA, Virtual Agent Academy. Submit. Going back to the web client, refreshing. And indeed, bottom left, notice the updated string here. So we could do the same for a specific language like Dutch. So let's change the show me everything, but now for the Dutch language. And again, within the UI message table, we'll just search for the message, show me everything. And there's one record available in Dutch, and we actually only have to update this message. So let me update this. Something like this. Then going to the Virtual Agent web client, changing my language to Dutch, and let's see if our change has been applied. Yeah, indeed. Our updated message has been applied. So that's really nice. Well, this way you could do a lot more, though it's the same principle, just applying UI messages. Let me switch back the language. Yeah, we are pretty good on time, so I can demonstrate one extra thing. On the Virtual Agent web client, when clicking the support options, notice there are different prefixes here, TRF. And that actually concerns the translated field names. So what if I would like to change the call support string? Well, actually we would navigate to system localization and then the translated name fields. And we would search for a value containing call support. And yeah, here we already have the English and Dutch records. So if wanting to change the message shown, in this case, just update the value of the label field. So it's pretty similar as the UI messages, only in this case, it concerns the translated name and fields. So let's just update this one. Let's say 7 a.m., 6 p.m. and VAA. And let's see if it got applied. Refresh. So the web client is refreshing. We don't see the update yet. I might have to do a cache.do. So let's see if that helps. Okay. Going back to the Virtual Agent web client again. Yeah, and indeed, now the updated support option has been applied. Obviously, you can do the same for other languages. So yeah, that's a short demonstration on localization on the Virtual Agent web client in English and a specific language. Yeah, not much to it. Are there maybe any questions already so far?
So Mark, no questions in the chat. I would encourage the audience to post your questions. This is a pretty hot topic around translations. But I do have a question. So when you're looking at the translated message, do customers usually make sure somebody in that specific localization can validate that the translation is accurate? Or how do you see customers making sure that the translated messages have the right context?
Yeah, that's a good question. With most of the customers I've been working on Virtual Agent, we've added also people from the specific departments, for example, the HR department, or for example, the service desk, because the service desk really has a lot of contact with the real customers. So obviously I can do a lot with the translations, the messages and things like that, but I'm thinking more with a IT mind and not with a customer's mind. So yeah, it's really about involving the correct teams, so the HR team or the service desk. That helps a lot.
Yeah, that's great information. So as customers are setting this up, it sounds like they need to make sure they have the right resources to make sure that the context is correct and the translation is going to be accurate. So thanks for that.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah, that's a good one. Okay. The last part of today's Virtual Agent Academy, some need to knows and limitations. The first two are on topic name translations and static choice labels, which are not shown correctly. I've mentioned two community articles here. If you would like to know more on these, just check out the articles mentioned. They describe this in great detail. Generic wording and sentences. Yeah, first would be careful when editing generic UI messages. Maybe these are used on multiple places in your instance, like what I mentioned on the just now string. This could have impact on your whole instance. Another one is application scope. If you are designing new topics and maybe doing so in a scoped application, where are you adding the UI messages, especially the generic ones, which could be used in other topics which might be in a different scope? So consider application scope for your generic UI messages. And editing existing values or UI messages. You could discuss on this one. For example, the menu item labels. Are you going to change these labels or are you going to update the translated text records? Like what I showed in the demo. Same for strings within topics. Are you changing those or are you updating the UI messages, message records, like I showed in the demo? I would suggest, if possible, go for updating the UI messages, translated text, those records. That helps maintainability a lot. And limitations. There are not many limitations with Virtual Agent, though there are some. string type fields, an important one. You must understand string type fields are just freeform text. On the system UI, there's dynamic translation available. You might also build your own Google API, for example. Though on this moment, out of the box, for Virtual Agent, string fields are just not translated. And last one, the Virtual Agent admin role. Maybe you are working with a form of delegated development. Some users have the Virtual Agent admin role to help develop topics. A big thing of today's Virtual Agent Academy are the UI messages. Though out of the box, the Virtual Agent admin role has no write access to the UI messages. So wrapping up, we had a look at localization for the Virtual Agent Designer and Virtual Agent Web Client. And lastly, I've touched on some need to knows and limitations concerning localization. Maybe there are any questions?
So no questions at this time. I would encourage everyone to ask now while we have Mark on the line. So if you have questions, please let us know. But Mark, this was a great presentation and a much needed topic for Virtual Agent Academy. So great stuff and important to know the limitations of what you can do and what you can't do.
A good thing to also mention again, when working on localization, do use the i18n debugging, because it really points you already in the direction, like what can be translated, what not, and where should you be? Is it UI messages? Is it translated text? Is it choices? So really make use of that.
So Mark, we have a great question around how virtual agent handles knowledge. So the question is, if a virtual agent topic queries and displays knowledge articles, will this automatically pull the article version that's in the user's language, or are there extra considerations? So an example would be if my language preference is set to Dutch, and I'm going through a virtual agent conversation, and as part of that conversation, it searches the knowledge base. If my organization has translated policies in Dutch, would I see those, or would I have to do anything special to make those show up?
I think I saw a similar question last week on the ServiceNow community. And actually, out of the box, if you would use, for example, the search knowledge topic, then you would see English and, well, in this case, Dutch or German knowledge articles. Though you can expand the condition for the knowledge search, or actually for the contextual search. I have to look it up because I did answer a similar question last week. But you could just post a question on the community and I can come back on that. Because you can filter it out to the specific language. It is possible, yeah.
Yeah, that's a great question. And typically the question I hear from customers is, you know, they'll want to see articles in their language and they may want to see articles for their direct reports. And those could be in different localizations. So this is a great question and I think very applicable. All right. Well, if there's no more questions, we can conclude today's session. Thank you, as always, Mark, for being a valued partner and contributor to Virtual Agent Academy. We really appreciate your contributions.
Great. Thank you. And thanks, everyone, for attending.